Okay, here's a 2012 four-cylinder Equinox LT in one of my favorite colors. This is Mocha Steel Metallic. I'll take you around this vehicle, show you some of the nice features of the 2012. Just want to demonstrate the color of this paint here in the Southern California sun. Let me get in close here so you can see this metallic. Alright, it's kind of tough with this little camera. There we go. There we go. Mocha Steel Metallic on jet black interior, cloth interior. Four cylinder with a six speed automatic transmission. This one does have the driver's convenience power seat. Does have the rear vision camera, XM satellite radio. It's a touch screen, LCD screen. Get some nice side views here of this vehicle. I get some more of this Mocha Steel with the sun on it. I think that's a better view of the Mocha Steel Metallic. And we're gonna shoot this video with a night view this evening. By the time you view this video, there'll probably be a night view of the interior of this vehicle. Has some nice illuminations. So I wanna show you that. Right from the factory, you got Michelin tires. 17 inch alloy rims. Four wheel disc brakes with four-wheel ABS. You have tire pressure monitors on all four tires. Color keyed mirrors and door handles. This one does have the roof rack. You'll notice that even on the front grille, this is all filled in just for some aerodynamics. Smaller venting front grille. This does have the remote start on the key, so what we'll do is we'll lock the door first and you'll see the lights light up there. So we're all locked, and then I'll hold this button down and we're all started. Car's all locked up. We'll unlock it and we'll go inside the vehicle. Is your power seat for the driver with lumbar support. Here's a good view of the cloth. One of the more comfortable small SUVs on the market today. Rated higher than a Lexus RX 350 at this point, according to third party review. Okay, so here we are. Remote start, steering wheel is locked. Cannot pull the transmission out of park, so we'll put the key in, we'll just simply turn it forward, and we're gonna light up, steering wheel unlocks. Nice display over there on the touchscreen stereo with XM radio. You'll notice that with this new screen, not only is it touchscreen, but also you have nice wallpaper in the background. You scroll through some of these different channels and you'll see that we'll get a different wallpaper back there. This doesn't have a premium stereo, but it does have great sound right from the factory. pick up something else here, like okay, Radio Disney for the kids. That's the record player. Scan the radio.
Playing. I'll share it with you this time.
A separate wallpaper.
But next, a former Giant player accuses Perry Hewitt.
I'm gonna go back to my favorite here in Asia. You see some different icons and indicators on the stereo. Those are touch buttons right there. Just go ahead and start down through here. The stereo controls right there. There's your lock and unlock for the doors. That is your child safety lock right there. You can just electronically lock and unlock the child safety locks on the door now. Heating, ventilation, air conditioning control, and then also your driver information center. This controls that. That is right there in the middle of your speedometer and your RPM gauge, vehicle information. Toggle through that just by using these buttons over here. Okay? Just one thing I want to point out about this vehicle is you may read online where someone may say that these controls right here are hard to reach. They're hard to reach for a reason. Should not be really messing with these controls unless you are parked or stopped at an intersection where it's safe, and then you simply lean forward. Very easy to touch those controls and make your selections. It's actually a smart idea for GM to put those controls up there out of the way, because this is where your hands should be. And the controls on the steering wheel or around the steering wheel, such as your wipers and your turn signals and your light controls, those are all right around the steering wheel, so you can safely keep your eyes on the road and still control the conveniences of your vehicle. Once again, I mean, even these automatic windows and mirrors, they're all within hand reach. Those over there, just leave them alone unless you're stopped. And that's a safety thing. All right, here's your transmission gate and shift. Obviously, that's easy to control as you're driving. In fact, you can, in manual mode, you can easily go shift up and down right there on the side of the gear shift. Got an eco mode button right there. If you press that, you're gonna see the eco light up. Any green light on your dash is a green light go. That just means that something is operating, and or it's just an indicator. But green means go. It's not a caution. A yellow light on your dash would mean caution or something has changed that you need to be aware of. And a red light on your dash means you've got a something that needs immediate attention, or you have a safety issue, such as a door being open, and I'll show you that right there. Okay, door is open. Well, that's actually going to be in the middle, but seatbelt is not on, brakes on, things like that. You don't want to drive the car with those red lights illuminated. The eco button, when you do press that, you're going to hear the engine make a little more noise when you're stopped at stoplights. The engine and transmission adjust their shift points to optimize your fuel economy and help the vehicle run better for the environment, saving you fuel. So over here you have your stereo controls and Bluetooth. On that side of the steering wheel, you do have your cruise control. The steering wheel is very much like a 2012 Camaro steering wheel. You're gonna see the same steering wheel on the 2013 Malibu. Really nice design and easy to get used to, even if you are not too crazy about it to begin with. Right here, you got your stable track stability control button. You turn it off. there's your traction control light lighting up. That's a caution. I probably would never turn that off. Cup holders right there.
There we go.
Here. Glove box. The cloth here. There's the rear. Show you some visibility on the driver's seat. Side airbags, overhead airbags, front airbags, all for your safety. This is a top International Institute of Highway Safety pick. Here's your mirrors with the blind spot additions on the outer portion. Those actually move with the mirror as you're adjusting them. These mirrors are also heated. As you can see right there, the indicator. There's nice visibility in this vehicle, actually. I'm gonna drop this into reverse. Show you the rear vision camera. I'm gonna drive this car around in reverse to get it lined up with the sun so you can actually see the rear bumper and all that good stuff. Sometimes the shadows make it difficult for us. Okay, so here we are. Definitely don't want to use a screen to drive with. It is just basically used to clear the vehicle. You still want to use your mirrors. They are very helpful. Okay, so here we go. I want to show you something. This outline right here, that is your rear bumper. So you can get pretty close to a vehicle without hitting it with this monitor. It's not designed for that, but let's face it, sometimes you gotta maneuver into a tight area. So something to be able to use. Let me pull back over here and we'll go over the rest of the vehicle on the outside and the engine. Okay. $26,600. Here's your second row. Here's your rear vision camera. This one does have all weather mats that are included in the sticker price. Seats do go down right here. Just grab the leather lever. And I can't get it from this side over here. Anyway, seats do go down 60-40 split. A lot of people think that on the four-cylinder that is a subwoofer. That is not a subwoofer. That is actually a noise canceling speaker system that the four cylinder uses, because the engine is adjusted, the valves are adjusted in a way to maximize its fuel economy. And because of that adjustment, the vehicle makes extra noise. But hey, it's not that bad when you cancel it out. Here's your spare tire. It's a temporary spare. Everyone always gets bummed out when they realize that it's not a full-size spare. What they don't realize is that tire right there can do the job, just like a full-size tire can. It's also a reminder to get your tire replaced. So don't worry if you have to use that temporary spare. It's more than capable of handling the vehicle's weight and driving conditions. You do want to put that tire in the rear of the vehicle. If you have a front flat, you need to move your rear tire to the front and put that tire in the back. And that's just because of the width of the tire and it's a low profile. The weight of the engine and the weight transfer when you hit the brakes on the car needs to come down on the full-size tire. But it is also easier to change. Let's go under the hood here. 2.4 liter Ecotec motor. First tune up, about 100,000 miles under normal driving conditions. This vehicle does have OnStar, a computer that will tell you when you need to change your oil. It monitors the oil life based on how you drive. Vehicle also comes with a 5-year 100,000 mile powertrain warranty. With that, you automatically get roadside assistance for those 5 years, 100,000 miles. It has a 3-year 36,000 mile bumper to bumper warranty. So here you have, folks, 2012 Chevy Equinox 4-cylinder LT. The driver convenience package does have the rear view camera and monitor, XM satellite radio for 3 months free, and 6 months turn-by-turn navigation through OnStar for free. If you'd like to test drive one of these vehicles, come visit us at O'Donnell Chevrolet, 100 South San Gabriel Boulevard, San Gabriel, California, 91776, or visit us online at odchevy.com, odonnellchevrolet.com, or you can call us at 62-